Hi there, Steve Walker here. Today I want to talk about trailing and why trailing is such a great thing. Be able to trail your boat to different destinations. And I've got laid out on the floor here a few charts that will help explain what I'm talking about.
See, when I first started selling trimarans, people used to ask me what my sailing area was. And I was a bit perplexed by this because I didn't really have a sailing area. I sailed all over the place. I took the boat to France and sailed there. I sailed in the South Coast and the Lake District, wherever. It didn't really occur to me that people might have a sailing area. And what they really meant was they had a radius around their home port, which was their sailing area. And to go and sail in all these different areas that I've been sailing in would be a big fag, you know, be a major summer holiday job to sail just from one end of the country to another. Whereas with trailing, well, you can get there in a day and then have a sailing holiday in a completely different place. And another advantage of trailing, for example, one day it was 23 degrees here in Chester, lovely day, smashing, let's go sailing. So I gathered a few friends together and we set off for Roche-on-Sea, which is where I would normally sail from. And as we approached, the temperature was going down and down and down, and we were driving into a cold front, and then the rain started and it was chucking it down. So we got a weather forecast on the phone and found that further along the coast it was not going to be at all bad, very nice in fact. So we kept driving, we got to Crickath, we launched the boat there, and we sailed to Harlech after we'd had our sandwiches, because we were hungry by then, and then we sailed back again. So we had a nice afternoon sailing in lovely weather, clear blue skies, nice water, and then we packed up the boat and drove back again along the North Wales coast. And when we drove through Colwyn Bay, it was still raining. That cold front had been stuck over Colwyn Bay for the whole day, and there were flash floods. Now, if you had a boat on a mooring at Conway, you wouldn't have gone sailing that day probably, because you wouldn't have been able to see. It would have been no fun. So you'd have had to call it all off. But because we had a trailing boat, a trailerable boat, a trailer sailor, we were able to still go sailing on this nice day. So really, that's what the advantage of a trailer sailor is. And the advantage of a trimaran over other trailer sailors is its light weight. You can tow a trimaran with a very modest car. And although I have a big car, because I have to tow bigger boats sometimes, I started off towing it with a Ford Focus 1600 engine. So it's a boat that can be used by people who are not massively wealthy, don't have the money to keep a boat in a marina, and you can sail to all these fantastic places. And Wales is a terrific place to sail. Lovely coastline, beautiful, beautiful scenery. North Wales coast is Wales' best kept secret.
I have sailed from Chester out along the River Dee to a place called Roche-on-Sea in Colwyn Bay. This is Colwyn Bay. And I quite often sail from here, but I've only sailed that journey the once. I've sailed from here out to the wind farm, which is on this bank, the Constable Bank. And I've sailed from here to Llandudno. And from Llandudno, I've sailed almost to the edge, the end of the Great Orme, but not quite. I sailed from Conway out around Puffin Island and down the Menai Straits. I've sailed from Beaumaris quite a lot of times, out to Puffin Island and back again. And I've sailed, in fact, one day I sailed all the way round Anglesey from Beaumaris in just 12 hours. Nelson said that anybody who can sail around Anglesey can sail around the world, so I take that as a compliment. I've sailed from Holyhead to Portincline, and I've sailed from Trevor to Portincline and back, and I've sailed from Pathelli to Portincline, and from Portincline up through the Menai Straits and back to Conway. So I've done all of this coastline, and a year or two ago I had a great holiday sailing in this area. Pathelli to Clanbedrog, Clanbedrog to Abersoch, Abersoch to Pathelli and on to Port Maddock, and from Port Maddock on to Aberdovey, from Aberdovey back to Barmouth. That was fun getting in there. And from Barmouth to Crickath, and then Crickath back to Pathelli. And that was a great holiday, good weather. Another occasion I sailed from Crickath to Port Merion, which is, this is Port Maddock up there, and there's a channel up to there. But there's also a possibility of getting up to Port Merion. Now, I was told by somebody who lived here that that was impossible, but I'd already done it. And the reason I'd been able to do it was because I was in a trimaran with very, very shallow draft. And you wouldn't be able to do it in a conventional yacht, which would have a keel. On another occasion, I motored from Chester to Crickath and sailed all the way to Newquay, down here. Stayed in bed and breakfast, and then sailed all the way back again the next day. And that was a good trip. And you can do day sailing from Milford Haven, and I went round here and up to Solva, and that was a lovely trip. I went really fast, very exciting round here off Skerma and Skokholme Islands. So, what do you notice in all of this? There's quite a lot of this area that I have yet to investigate, but in my local area, North Wales, there's a gap here at the Great Orme's Head. The Great Orme is a really significant piece of land in this overall landscape. You can see it very clearly from Beaumaris, sticks out away out of the land. This is where Llandudno is, in that little gap. When I grew up as a child in Wallasey, you could see the Great Orme from the top of our road. So it's very, very important. Here's an old chart dated 1771. This is a very unusual chart. Its main feature is the fact that it's upside down. North is down here, and that's magnetic north, and that is the Wirral Peninsula, so we would normally see that the other way up. And this is, as you would approach Liverpool in a ship, you would be coming in following these leading lights, Bidston and Leeso lighthouses, which are lined up, and go in this way to get into Liverpool, which was only a tiny little place in those days. And on the edge of the chart, over here, is a view of what you would see as you're coming in this way. You would see the Great Orme. And a very significant feature on the Great Orme is the lighthouse at the end. And this lighthouse has been built upside down. That's to say the light is at the bottom of it rather than at the top of it, so that it doesn't get shrouded in fog. But it's no longer lit, and it's been turned into a hotel. And I was lucky enough to spend a night there. And it's been featured on television quite a few times. But I've never sailed around here, and this is what I wanted to do. So, this summer, I did it. Chose a good day with sunshine and a very high tide. Motored out to Conway and launched the boat when that water was very high, and sailed out over what looks like dry land here. But we had so much water underneath us, there was absolutely no danger at all. And when we got around to the top of the Great Orme, there are overfalls there. So it was quite lively and fun sailing, surfing, doing about 12 knots. I was too busy actually sailing to get the camera out and operate it myself and take photographs of the lighthouse. But just afterwards, we got a bit of video on Julie's iPhone. Then we pass some goats. Now, these goats are famous for being rounded up by the army each year because they need one for their mascot. Then we went into Llandudno and we anchored there and left the mainsail up. We don't need to take it down. The boat's quite happy sitting at anchor with the mainsail up, as long as you furl a jib. And we watched all the people enjoying themselves on the pier and on motorboats, speedboats, day trippers. We could hear the Punch and Judy.
Who should look after the baby for me?
It was a nice thing to have done. And then of course we had to sail back again. This is the black track that you see on these little diagrams. And the whole day we had a westerly wind, so we had to beat against the wind on the way back. But fortunately the tide was with us, and not so strong at this time of the day, and the wind was not so strong, so it wasn't too rough going around the tip of the Great Orme. But we then had to get back via the main channel, which was quite a long way, and by the time we got into it, there was virtually no water left in it. And inevitably, the centerboard kicked up and the rudder kicked up, and we had to take the sail down and motor in the rest of the way, because we can sail in virtually no water. As long as you can see water when you're in a trimaran, you can probably get over it. It only needs to be ankle deep and you can sail on it. So we motored back in, and then there was again a little bit of a problem getting the boat out because the slipway had disappeared halfway up the bank. It didn't come all the way down to the bottom. And so we attached a rope to the trailer, and some helpful passers-by helped us get the boat out and up the slipway. And then there was a lovely sunset, and it was the end of a great day. And I'd completed that coastline from here in Chester, where I'm standing now, all the way to Newquay. There's not a bit that I've missed. Anyway, I hope that's been helpful to you. If you have found it helpful, I would like you to click on any like buttons that you see around this video. And that will help to spread the word about the video to other people. And if you'd like to try or buy one of these boats, then please give me a call. If you want a bigger boat or a second-hand one, then I can help you with that as well. And I sell boats at all times of the year. You might be lucky and find that I'm selling my demonstrator, as this customer was, and pick up a bargain. Never ceases to amaze me that people do buy boats in the middle of the winter, but they do. So I hope that's whet your appetite for buying a trimaran day boat. Sailing has been going on for thousands of years, so really this sort of a boat is a new idea. And not many people have experienced sailing in trimarans, so there's not much point in asking people who haven't sailed in them what they're like and what the pros and cons of them are, because they don't know. But I know, because I've been sailing in them for 12 years. So give me a call, have a chat about it, and I hope that I'll be able to serve you. I hope this has served you, and that you now know more about trimarans than you did before. Please pick up the phone and call me now.